Do you feel pretty comfortable with your aim, but still seem to miss a bunch of shots in Apex? We've all been there, laying down some fire at a mid-range target and being baffled when you aren't getting damage indicators. How's it going, guys? My name is Valued, and make sure you pay attention today because we're gonna break down why you miss your shots, and it might not be the reason that you thought. Okay, so regardless of how good your aim is, if you don't understand the weapon you're using down to its finest detail, you will miss some shots. Bullet velocity, recoil, and fire rate are the three most important features of a weapon that impact your aim. And knowing these aspects of each weapon will have you hitting more shots in no time. There are a ton of guns in the game, so it can be a bit overwhelming to have a feel for each gun at all times unless you're playing the game a ton. But don't worry, because ammo types have got you covered. While each gun is definitely unique, the type of ammo they use tells you a lot about the weapon characteristics. From bullet velocity and bullet drop to fire rate and recoil, knowing exactly how each ammo type behaves will have a massive impact on your aim and your ability to hit your shots. While there are a few weapons that are unique, I'm looking at you, bow, check, and charge rifle, most weapons will be similar to other guns in its ammo type, with a few key differences. Now, let's take a close look at each of the weapon types, talk about a couple different guns, and some considerations you need to make when taking fights with each type of weapon. Starting off, we have light ammo. This ammo type has high bullet velocity and very little drop in most situations. The bullet drop doesn't really start to affect these weapons too much until very long ranges. At close and medium range, you shouldn't have to worry about leading your target too much, and hitting your shots will be a lot easier than some other weapon types. This being said, light weapons also do the least amount of damage per shot, but they have high fire rates to make up for it, aside from the P2020. With the automatic weapons like the R301 and the R99, you want to be unloading your clip as fast as possible while tracking your target. With the low damage and high fire rate, you've really got to make sure your aim is on point to make the most out of these weapons. Light weapons are some of the most popular because they're often the easiest to hit shots with. At most ranges, there is very little leading needed, and it makes these weapons feel like most other FPS games. The only real oddball for these weapons is the G7 Scout, which can be a bit tricky to get used to because it has a lot of drop for a long-range weapon. The key with this gun, and any weapons for that matter, is to have the proper sight equipped. If you're using a Scout with a 1X on it, that doesn't really set you up for success because this weapon excels at long range. Make sure you have the sights on your weapons that reflect their power and you're using the weapons in situations that play to their strengths. Consistently having a 3X or more on a Scout will make hitting your shots so much easier. And the same goes for close range weapons. There's no reason to have a 3X on your flatline if you're using it up close, or to put a 2X on your shotties for some reason. Having sights that allow you to have a full target to hit at whatever range you're fighting is key, but make sure you're actually using a weapon that is meant for that range. That's the real key. I'm talking to you guys that spray your R9s from long range. If you find yourself missing your shots and you're looking for a one-stop shop solution, Imperial Hal has an amazing opportunity for you.
Hey, what's up everyone? I'm Imperial Hal and welcome to my brand new Apex class. This class goes over everything you need to move, shoot, and think like me. Whether you're silver or diamond, controller or keyboard, you're going to be the one carrying your friends.
I typically can't get to all your comments, but this course is actually going to help you guys so much in all your questions.
If you're serious about becoming a better Apex player, join me for the next 30 days and commit to improving.
So, quick tip before we hop into the heavy weapons, hit your first shot. Whether you're using a light weapon or any other weapon type, landing a shot on an enemy slows their movement speed. It's nothing crazy, but the slight movement speed decrease makes all your following shots a lot easier to hit. Even if it isn't your first shot out of the clip, make sure you deal some damage before you commit to a full auto spray, and it will make hitting those shots a whole lot easier. So now we're gonna go into an ammo type that this rule we just talked about is so important for. For heavy ammo, you have some very different considerations to make than its light ammo counterpart. With heavy weapons, bullets tend to do a lot more damage, but have a slower fire rate and a slower travel speed. These weapons can do some damage, but players often struggle to get the fire rates and bullet velocities down, causing them to miss a ton of shots. So let's take the Rampage for an example. This gun is a beast. If you hit every shot, you will down people incredibly fast, even without the thermite charge. However, this weapon has two key features that many of the heavy weapons have that players struggle with: fire rate and bullet velocity. Having a lower bullet spread means that you're going to need to lead your shots quite a bit at longer ranges, making these weapons pretty hard to hit shots with if you aren't used to them. When compared to something like an R301, the Rampage asks for more precision to consistently land your shots. But what's interesting is the Rampage has a lot more bullets in the clip and a lower fire rate, meaning it has much higher uptime than these other weapons. Now, this one makes sense because it is an LMG, but it's important to realize for a couple of key reasons. First, the longer uptime on a weapon, the more room you have to correct your aim. If you're using an R99, for example, the fire rate is so high that you need to be very accurate for a second or two before getting to the end of your clip. This means if you miss the first couple of shots, it's really easy to just whiff the rest of them. However, with something like the Rampage, if you take your first few shots and you're just off, you can take a second to recenter yourself, let the recoil reset, and take some more shots. This is important to realize because all too often, players get trigger happy and just unload their bullets at someone even if they're barely hitting their shots. And guys, keep in mind the longer you're firing, the tougher time you're gonna have controlling the recoil, leading to missing more shots. And that's the second bonus of the large clip and low fire rate of the Rampage. You have the freedom to reset your recoil mid-fight. With the R99 example used before, if you're not unloading your clip, the gun really isn't that good. But with something like the Rampage, you can and should reset your recoil or even just pace your shots a bit to lower how much recoil you're receiving. This can be super helpful for hitting shots at long ranges and really opens up your mind on how to control your weapons. Knowing all the attributes of your gun like this beyond just the recoil pattern or the damage is what will let you get so much more value out of your aim. Speaking of getting value out of your aim, energy ammo is probably the easiest to do just that. Think light ammo with a faster travel time and no bullet drag, meaning much less shots to lead. This ammo type tends to be a fast fire rate with low damage, but the raw accuracy makes the bullet so much easier to hit, in theory. Aside from the Volt and the L-Star, every energy weapon in the game has a wind-up time and pretty serious recoil. Weapons like the Havoc and Devotion are two of the harder weapons to use, with the turbocharger being a must and the recoil being pretty drastic. Even the L-Star has a decent amount of recoil. This being said, these weapons put a heavy emphasis on recoil control. With the ammo type being so accurate, if you can manage to control the recoil and account for the wind-up times, these weapons are strong. Like, guys, there's a reason everybody you run into is spamming the L-Star right now. The only weapon that doesn't have these weaknesses are the Volt, and this gun has been meta basically since its release. Even with it being a submachine gun, you can see the potential of energy weapons as soon as you pick it up, and it makes you understand why these weapons require so many attachments to make them work. Energy ammo has a pretty steep damage falloff, and when combined with the recoil of the weapons, they definitely excel in close and medium ranges. My tip for these weapons would be learn the recoil patterns like the back of your hand. And if you have them down, each of these weapons is lethal. And if you're anything like me, don't even bother with the weapons that need a turbocharger unless you already have one or you're just off spawn. If you keep that rule in mind, the Volt and the L-Star will become your best friends, assuming the L-Star doesn't get nerfed anytime soon. All right, so let's talk about shotties and snipers real quick. These ammo types are basically the opposite of each other. Sniper ammo is going to have very low damage drop-off at range and have the ability to collateral players, barriers, and traps. Snipers are true to their name and have big damage with low fire rates. And if you're using the charge rifle, you actually skip out on a majority of these drop-offs. Shotties have major damage drop-off, but pack a big punch in close ranges. While the Peacekeeper can charge up and get some solid range, all the shotties are very bad outside of close range encounters due to this drop off and their pellet spread. But guys, both these weapon types are very straightforward. Use snipers at long range and shotties at close range. These weapons are less about recoil control and more about quick, precise aiming for short stints. Other than the charge rifle, the snipers have a bit of drop that you need to worry about, with the longbow being the biggest offender. However, for both these weapons, you're looking to quickly acquire a target, shoot, acquire a target, shoot, and so on. The snipers especially will test your aim due to the far ranges and the low fire rate. However, if you get the bullet drop down, every sniper can be deadly. If you're struggling with some of the snipers, then give the charge rifle a try until you're a bit more comfortable sniping. And for shotties, you just have to be fast about acquiring targets at close range. There's really no extra bullet drop or fancy stuff to worry about. Just you, your aim, and your shoddy's fire rate. All right, guys, whether you've been struggling with your aim or we're just looking for a quick refresher, I know if you approach your weapon choices the way we have in this video, you'll be dealing some serious damage. There is so much more to landing shots than just good aim, and once you realize that, you will have a much better time navigating all of the game's weapons. Let me know in the comments below what weapons you find tough to use or one that you've recently mastered. Anyway, guys, my name is Valued, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.